Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, we'll do the current affairs of 24th of February. So let's start the video. Let's start first with the quiz questions. So here are the 20 questions. With which sport will you associate the CK Naidu Trophy? So CK Naidu Trophy is related to which important sport? Yasin Merchant, he was related to which sport? He is a veteran. And these four questions were asked in the AFCAT exam few days back. Where is the headquarter of ICAO, International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO? What is the capital of Brunei? Not the easiest of capitals to remember, but you still got to do it. So what is the capital of Brunei? Keshopur Mayani Community Reserve is in which state? Keshopur Miani. Shiva Samudram Falls is in which state? It's a very important fall, Shiva Samudram. Who is the author of the Hindi novel Balwa? B-A-L-W-A, Balwa. Who is the author of the Hindi novel Balwa? Pinky Jangra is related to which sport? She was in news recently, Pinky Jangra. India's first war memorial for animals will come up in which city? There will be a war memorial now for the animals as well. When do we observe the foundation day of UP, Uttar Pradesh? Which date? Mombasa port is located in which country? Mombasa. It's a very important international port. Aga Khan Award is given for which field? According to Greenpeace India report, which is the least polluted city in India? Least polluted, not the most polluted. The Indian Electrical and Electronics Manufacturers Association, they are hosting Electrama 2020 in which city? Indian Electrical and Electronics Manufacturers Association, Electrama 2020 will be hosted in which city? Who was appointed as the chairman and managing director of Air India recently? Who is the governor of Gujarat? Governor of Gujarat. What is the currency of Denmark? The Scandinavian country Denmark. Who was appointed as the new finance secretary of India recently? Antalya is a city in which country? Antalya, Antalya. And Arvind Kejriwal, what is his constituency in Delhi? In the recently concluded Vidhan Sabha or Legislative Assembly elections in Delhi, he contested from which constituency? He is the Chief Minister of Delhi. So now let me tell you the answers. CK Naidu Trophy is related to cricket. It is related to cricket. Yasin Merchant is related to snooker. He is a veteran snooker player. Headquarter of International Civil Aviation Organization is in Montreal, which is in Canada. Montreal is a French-speaking territory in Canada. Now, I must also tell you here that the headquarter of World Anti-Doping Agency and International Air Transport Association is also in Montreal. World Anti-Doping Agency and IATA, International Air Transport Association, also in Montreal. Capital of Brunei is Bandar Seri Begawan. It's quite difficult to remember. B-A-N-D-A-R, Bandar Seri, S-E-R-I, Begawan, B-E-G-A-W-A-N. Keshopur Miani Community Reserve is in Punjab. It's a Ramsar site, recently declared Ramsar site in Punjab. Shiva Samudram Falls, you will find it in Karnataka. Chamarajnagar district, Karnataka. Shiva Samudram Falls, very, very important tourist place. Hindi novel Balwa is written by Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Pinky Jangra is related to boxing, not wrestling, boxing. And India's first war memorial for animals is coming up in Meerut, M-E-R-R-U-T, Meerut. Foundation Day of UP is one day before the National Voters Day, which is 24th of January. So 24th of January is the Foundation Day of UP, Uttar Pradesh. Mombasa port is in Kenya. It's a very important trading port, Kenya. Aga Khan Award is given for architecture. Now I told you another important for architecture, which is Pritzker Prize. So Pritzker Prize and Aga Khan Award, they both are given for excellence in architecture. Greenpeace India report, the least polluted city in India is Lung Lei. It is in Mizoram. L-U-N-G-L-E-I, Lung Lei. Electrama 2020 is taking place in Greater Noida in Uttar Pradesh, Greater Noida in UP. Chairman and Managing Director of Air India is Rajiv Bansal. He succeeded Ashwani Lohani. Rajiv Bansal is now the Chairman of Air India. Arvind Kejriwal constituency is called New Delhi. So he contested elections from New Delhi Assembly constituency. Antalya is a city you will find in Turkey. In Turkey, there are three important cities. One is Istanbul, the most important one. Then the capital is Ankara. And of course, very similar sounding, Antalya. The new finance secretary, earlier it was Rajiv Kumar, and now it is Debashish Panda. Don't forget this name. Finance secretary is a very important position. The minister of state in the Ministry of Finance is Anurag Thakur from Hamirpur constituency. And of course, cabinet minister is Nirmala Sitharaman. Currency of Denmark is Kron, K-R-O-N-E, Kron. And the governor of Gujarat is Acharya Devrat. Acharya Devrat, the former governor of Himachal, now the governor of Gujarat, Acharya Devrat. So quiz was, I think it was moderate, easy to moderate, I would say. Some questions were really easy, some were moderate. So it is a mixed bag for you, but how many were you able to do out of 20? So do let me know. Now let's start the current affairs of today. International Judicial Conference 2020 was organized in which city? International Judicial Conference was organized in New Delhi. And it was organized by the Supreme Court of India, which is the apex court, which means it is the highest court, right? And the law minister is Ravi Shankar Prasad. Ravi Shankar Prasad constituency is Patna Sahib in Bihar. He is also the minister for telecom. He is also the minister for electronics, information technology. So a lot of ministries he is heading right now. Remember, our Chief Justice is S.A. Bobade. He is from Nagpur, S.A. Bobade. And we have 34 judges in the Supreme Court. Earlier, there were 31, including the Chief Justice. Now, there are 34. You can also write it as 33 plus 1. 33 other judges and one is the Chief Justice of India. And the retirement age for a Supreme Court judge is 65. And the retirement age for a High Court judge is 62. Who has been appointed as the pro tem speaker of the Delhi Assembly? The pro tem speaker is Shoaib Iqbal. Shoaib Iqbal, he was appointed by the governor, Lieutenant Governor Anil Baijal. Anil Baijal is the Lieutenant Governor of New Delhi. And Iqbal was, he won the elections from Matia Mahal constituency. From Matia Mahal constituency in Delhi. And the election results were 62-8. 62 Aam Aadmi Party, 8 BJP. And total there are 70 seats in the Delhi Legislative Assembly. There are 7 seats in the Lok Sabha in Delhi. And there are 3 seats in the Rajya Sabha in Delhi. Government has given its approval for the formation of how many farmer producer organizations over the next 5 years? So total 10,000 farmer producer organizations will be set up in India. Will be set up by 2024, and this will ensure economies of scale for farmer. Economies of scale means when you produce something in bulk, you can produce it at a cheaper rate. And there will be a lot of implementing agencies like NABARD, NCDC, SFAC, etc. But just remember the number 10,000. Leo Varadkar has resigned from the post of Prime Minister of which country? So Leo Varadkar was the Prime Minister of Ireland. He was the Prime Minister of Ireland, and now there will be a new Prime Minister of Ireland. The new Prime Minister so far has not been decided. But let me tell you the elections were won on the basis of unification of Ireland. So there are two Ireland. This Ireland is the Republic of Ireland, but there is another one called Northern Ireland. So Republic of Ireland capital is Dublin, and Northern Ireland capital is Belfast. And both of these will be unified. This was the election promise of the winning party. Indian government will procure 24 MH-60R Seahawk multi-role helicopter from which country? MH-60R Seahawk helicopter. These are also called Romeo helicopters. So these will be procured from Lockheed Martin Company of America. So the answer is America. You need to remember the name of the company which produces these helicopters. It is Lockheed Martin. They will be procured from US government. And this deal is worth $2.6 billion. That also you need to remember. $2.6 billion. Earlier we also bought Apache helicopter made by Boeing and Chinook helicopter again made by Boeing from America. Apache and Chinook. Chinook are the transport helicopter and Apache is the attack helicopter. Which will be the first country to host the new format of AIBA Team World Cup in 2020? AIBA, so it will be Russia. Russia, and this decision was taken recently, and the tournament will also coincide with the 75th anniversary of the victory in the World War II. The motto will be Boxing for Peace. See, AIBA is the International Association for Boxing. So Boxing for Peace, and it will be hosted by Russia. You Win Mint, who will be on the official visit to India, is the president of which country? So You Win Mint is the president of Myanmar. Myanmar's capital is Naypyidaw, and in Myanmar, you remember, there is a port also called Sitwe Port, S-I-T-T-W-E. The old name of Myanmar is Burma. Which stadium has become India's first green-rated cricket stadium? Which is it? It is Motera Stadium in Ahmedabad. Motera Stadium in Ahmedabad, the world's largest cricket stadium, housing 110,000 people, and also the site for Namaste Trump. Now, there is another stadium in Ahmedabad, which is the first stadium to have a roof, and that will be the Rajkot Stadium. So, remember both the stadiums. And what is the meaning of this green-rated stadium? It will have 100% LED lighting. So, it will have rainwater harvesting. It will have sewage treatment facility and all that. What is the official slogan for the FIFA Under-17 Women's World Cup? The official slogan is Kick of the Dream. Kick of the Dream. And Under-17 Women's World Cup is taking place in various places. Ahmedabad, Bhubaneswar, Guwahati, Kolkata, Navi Mumbai. So, lot of places have been confirmed. These five places have been confirmed so far. And just remember that FIFA Under-17 World Cup this time is taking place in India. India will be the guest of honor at the International Tourism Fair of which country? India will be the guest of honor in Madagascar Tourism Fair. Madagascar's capital is Antananarivo. It is located in the Indian Ocean. Antananarivo. And who is India's ambassador to Madagascar? Abhay Kumar. Try to remember his name, Abhay Kumar. He is India's ambassador to Madagascar. What was the rank of India in the Sustainability Index? In the Sustainability Index, India was ranked 77th out of 131 countries. And it was commissioned by World Health Organization and UNICEF and also Lancet, L-A-N-C-E-T. WHO, UNICEF and Lancet, they gave this index. Which is the number one country in this index? Number one country was Norway. Norway was number one, then South Korea was number two, Netherlands was number three. But just remember, Norway was number one. Who has been elected as the president of the Rowing Federation of India? Rowing Federation of India, new president is Rajalakshmi Dev. Rajalakshmi Singh Dev. In fact, she has been re-elected. Earlier also she was the president, now also she is the president. Who is the author of the book, Who is Bharat Mata? Who is Bharat Mata? This book is written by Purushottam Agarwal. And this book is about Nehru. You know, this book is about Nehru. It's basically a biography of Nehru. Which movie has won the Best Film Award at the Dadasaheb Phalke International Film Festival Award 2020? The best film is Super 30. Best film is Super 30. Best actor is Hrithik Roshan. So just remember two awards. Best film is Super 30. Best actor is Hrithik Roshan. And now can you tell me Hrithik Roshan played the role of which person in the movie Super 30? Ashok Chatterjee passed away. He was associated with which sport? He was a football player. Ashok Chatterjee was a football player. Who have been appointed as advisors to the Prime Minister Modi? Which of these? Bhaskar Khulbe, Amarjit Sinha, Rajiv Ranjan. The answer is A and B. Bhaskar Khulbe and Amarjit Sinha, they have been appointed advisors to the Prime Minister of India. Ross Taylor has become the first player in the cricketing world to play 100 matches in all the three formats of the game. He plays for which country? Ross Taylor is the first person in the history of cricket to play 100 T20 plus 100 Test plus 100 One Day, all the three. He is from New Zealand. New Zealand Prime Minister is Jacinda Ardern. Which state has launched Project Tej? Project Tej has been launched by the government of Telangana. It's a platform to help entrepreneurs and they will be able to test their innovative ideas in the field of medical technologies. So the answer is Telangana. In Telangana, Hyderabad, the world's biggest meditation center was also opened recently regarding mindfulness. And Telangana, also remember, it is the first state to start face recognition app for elections. Recently, some elections were conducted in Telangana, local election, where facial recognition technology was used for the first time. Fessenheim nuclear reactor, it was in news recently. It belongs to which country? It belongs to France. And it is right there on the border with Germany. And this nuclear reactor was in news because it will be shut down. So the answer is France, it will be shut down. Another nuclear reactor that you need to know is called Academic Lomonosov. It is a world's first floating nuclear reactor. Academic Lomonosov of Russia. What is the GDP growth that is projected by National Council of Applied Economic Research for India for financial year 2020? So according to NCER, our growth will be 4.9%. 4.9%, this is lower than what NSO has projected, National Statistical Office, which has projected 5% for the current financial year. What about for the next financial year? For the next financial year, NCER expects India's growth to pick up to 5.6%. That is for financial year 2021. So that's it. See you. God bless you. Take care.